Hey Legionnaires and welcome back. We're here with another Rise of Mordor Battlefield today, and this is a nice 1v1 between Dol Amroth and the Woodland Realm with large armies. As you can see here, we have some mounted Tarnusian Lancers breaking through Woodland Realm defense, I guess. I was about to call it Woodland Lime, and that just sounded very weird. What even would a Woodland Lime look like? But anyway, if you're enjoying seeing Rise of Mordor on the channel at the moment and would like to see more, then do remember to leave a like, subscribe if you're new around here, and leave a comment to show your support, as always. And I hope you do enjoy this one. It is a very, very close battle. Definitely worth checking out till the end to see how long it is going to go. And as you can see, there's the timer up there. We have 68 minutes, so it's probably going to be a fairly long one. So definitely get some snacks and some drinks and get yourself settled for what is going to be a truly epic battle. As you can see here, these Tarnusian Lancers are going to come around for round two of charging into these swords. Hopefully they can hold them back. I mean, they are forming shield wall, and they like they break through, but it's such a thin shield wall that like they break through instantly. So, like the shield wall like effect is just doing nothing to stop the cavalry. They need to form like a smaller one, but obviously then they can't defend the whole street. But yeah, they've lost about 40 men in a unit now, so I mean they've got to be careful. But I mean the defenders are massively outnumbered by at least It's like 2,100 men, basically. But these are elves, so they should be able to take down a fair amount of these Dol Amroth troops. Unless, obviously, they get charged constantly by these Tarnusian Lancers, which may be the case. When they're falling back here, they're going to fall back already to this little choke point here. And that means they're going to have to give up everything along this front as well. And that means that archers may get left up on these walls. Now, archers use a lot of ammo already. Look at this. They've used so much ammo, I think, just shooting these... shoot these towers, which they just don't need to do because that's just like wasting ammo. They've done like fire damage 42%, but they're using normal arrows. Look at this, they're just putting all their arrows right into the front of that sea tower. It's just such a waste of ammo, especially elven ammo as well. It's like gold dust, and they got another good charge off there. They damaged that last guard even more. It's not even probably got any kills since it's on 31 men. But here we go, the first clash of infantry has begun. And it's going to be between some Seaward Infantry and some Lasgarland Blades. But this was sent in by a member of the Discord, so you'd like to join the Discord to get involved in some battles of yourself, which they may then feature on the channel, or just to send in your own. The link is down below in the description of this video. I fully recommend coming and joining. We have a great small community going on, and yeah, everyone's really nice there. So I mean, if you would like, and you're struggling to find like Rise of Mordor games, or just any Total War games, or you just want to play with myself or other fellow subs, then do feel free to join the Discord down below in the description. As these Tarnusian Lancers kind of get like a bit stuck in all this blob of elves here, they need to be careful they don't get themselves stuck in any more blobs like that. But I mean, they're going to charge into spears in a moment. No, they're not. They're going to turn around and go for these guys again. Not a bad idea. But yes, as you can see, we are playing on Umbar. Umbar is quite a nice map. It's a huge map. It's kind of a shame there's like only two armies here. They are large armies though, so I guess it's like having a 2v2. I was about to say a 4v4, but that doesn't work. And there you go, the cavalry going in again. These Tarnusian Lancers, I bet, have got like well over 100 kills. Maybe 200. They're not as good as, like, say, the Swan Knights, but they're still pretty good. So I've been told. And as you can see here, I mean, this is a nice little spot here to set up and obviously shoot at stuff. But, I mean, the elves have an even better spot. Like, look at this. This is higher ground. I mean, they can't even see. Like, these Lasgarland archers can't even see the mass over here. So these guys are, like, just stuck in the open. So they need to really, like, get to maybe, like, here and start shooting. I would think. Well, they want to be like shooting from here onto that blob there. I don't know. Who knows? It looks like the elves are about to get caught out with their archers. I just send in these like these Seaward infantry here. They just need to go in, cut these guys down, and there we go into combat. Elven archers are okay in combat. Some of the better archers in combat, but they probably will still get overwhelmed. And now they're falling back behind their line of their shield wall. They're like, get back! Get back behind the shield wall! A mix of spears and swords defending this. I mean, I think it's the swords of the archers. But as always, this mod looks great. Always looks great. Just about in every, like, view I have it in, it just looks amazing. These Tarnuni still answers. They've got a little gap they could go around here. That is, like, how that's how sneaky you need to be in some Rise of Mordor games. Just little gaps like that. Sneak through with a cavalry unit or shock infantry and go for it. Or they could just plow infantry through here. And then they could just come and take this tower, these towers, and then just surround all these guys. I mean, they're easily for the taking, those elves. Back over on this side, I mean, it looks like the elves are losing pretty decisively. That unit of 31's now down to 19. I mean, they've had a hard time already just fighting the cavalry. They're having an even harder time now fighting some Seaward infantry. Fresh Seaward infantry as well. I love like the armor, like, difference in color, like the silver just against like the bronzy gold. It looks awesome. Just like, it's so easy to tell who's who. And look at this. You can see the elves are sending more stuff. Oh, luckily, Dolamroth, like, sewed his own charge down by charging into his own infantry. But, like, yeah, he just, like, left another Lasgallon blade here just to kind of, like, stop and, or get charged. Luckily, this one wasn't so bad. They could definitely probably send those swords back up now if they wanted to, like, their reserves, and cut down these Tarnosian lances once and for all. Because they're the only ones causing issues right now. But they're actually pulling through, and I think they're going to go after the next lot. They're not going to allow these elves to get away. I mean, where are they retreating? They're going to have to go all the way. Oh, I guess they could go up here. I think that's the way they were going. Oh, there's some more Tarnosian lances all the way around there. Jeez, they have a lot of cavalry. But this is Dol Amroth, so it's to be expected. And Dol Amroth's allowing the elves to get away. I mean, you should just hammer and anvil this unit then. If he's not going to go after these ones, hammer and anvil the one in combat. It's already losing anyway. Yes, these are two of the favoured factions, I would say. Oh my gosh, Tarnosian lances over here getting absolutely focused down. 24 men, and I think they've been focused down by archers. Yeah, Lasgallon archers just focus these guys down. But yeah, these are two favoured factions, I would say, certainly in Rise of Mordor. You often see Dol Amroth used and the elves. And here we go, got a charge into the back by Tarnosian lances. So it'd be interesting to see who wins out in this one. I mean, obviously, these are both very strong factions in their own regards. So it will be interesting to see. A lot of people, strangely, don't like seeing Dol Amroth win. Like, I've seen, like, comments and like, oh, I hate it when Dol Amroth wins. I mean, maybe because they just think that Dol Amroth's too OP, maybe. But then, so the Wooden Realm, I would say. They're probably one of the strongest factions in this game, if not the strongest. So maybe people will be a bit, like, undecided who they'd like to see win. Would you like to see the elves, like, the immortal elves that are just insanely good in combat? Or would you like to see the OP men faction, Dol Amroth win? Man faction, men faction? I don't know. But would you, yeah, it's going to be interesting to tell. I think Dol Amroth's got a few weaknesses in some areas, like archers. I don't think their archers are that great compared to, say, like the elven ones, which is, to be no surprise, to be honest, the elves have the best archers in Middle-earth. Like these, I mean, they've got archer militia here. I think that's all they brought for archers. Which is, I mean, the best they can bring is Nimrodel Rangers, but they're still, like, they've got ability, nearly, like, as good an ability as the Elven Archers, but they have no armor. So if you just shoot at the Nimrodel Rangers, they'll die pretty quickly. They have little to no missile block and little armor, so they're easy to kill off. So that's, like, a strength that the Elves possess, is that really good archer ability. But they have no cavalry, this is the Wooden Realm, compared to, like, Lindon, who has cavalry. These guys only can bring the Elven King, and I don't think I've spied the Elven King in this game. And he's only one unit you can bring. I mean, he's a very expensive unit. Yeah, he's not here today. We have the Lord's Lasgallon here today. So yeah, no Elven King to cause any problems. So this Mounted Tarnosian Lancers is probably going to be okay. I mean, the General's still out there with the catapult with a lot of ammo, which I'd definitely be thinking about bringing in. Shock Infantry? Well, I don't think the Elves brought any, but if they had, they'd Hall Guardians would have been greatly needed today. I always think they're a necessity to bring when you're playing as them, but certainly Dol Amroth's got strong shock as well. These Haven Guard are nasty. Regularly getting into the 300 kills, these guys. They don't ever disappoint, really. And they look awesome. They really, really do. I mean, look at that, like, armor down there. It just looks awesome. Like, don't even know what you call that. It's like a metal skirt almost, isn't it? Looks awesome. And then what have we got here? We've got some Javis, fishermen, levy skirmishes. Okay, so they're not bringing the Belfast Marines or whatever they've got, Pelennor Marines or something like that. Pelagir Marines. I think they've got one or the other. They've got like Belfast or Pelagir. But they have a Javi unit, but they bought the cheaper one. Oh, you got Haven Guard in here now. I didn't even realize. Haven Guard getting kills. It's just fun watching the duels and just seeing, like, who's going to win. Will it be the guy with a massive two-handed sword, or will it be someone with, like, a really small but nimble blade? And at the moment, it looks like it's going to be the guys with the massive swords. They are winning decisively in this fight. I mean, they have the support of these spears as well. Which is no surprise. Shock should easily mop up archers, even if they're elven archers. But yes, these poor elves in their own little pocket, they are in trouble. But men are breaking over here. Seaward infantry now breaking. I think they're coming up this hill. And they're getting absolutely focused down. Oh my gosh, look at all these guys that just died to arrows. That is, like, terrifying. See, like, some of them still struggling, and they're getting trampled by their comrades. But yeah, it's not even, like, anything stop them here. Oh, they're just going to do it the same thing as well? No. Clearly, like, the last unit that broke just stood here and sucked up a load of fire. These guys need to just carry on. Got to go up here, engage this spear unit. Like, the archers are just going to obviously, like, decimate them. And, like, the elves have, like, so much left, actually. They've, like, retreated a lot to the final position, but they did quite early on get unlocked. I mean, they're going to lose a lot here anyway. Well, to this little mess. But they have got still quite a lot left. So, even though the elves having a hard start, I'm not ruling them out. I mean, I've seen the Warden Realm do magical things in this mod. Brought back battles that looked like they were on the verge of defeat anyway, but no, the Warden Realm, with their elite units and their very good skill with bows and swords and spears, they've just about beaten anyone. And there you go. I think they're all breaking now. I think that's all the archers gone. It is. Oh, there's a spear unit, like, just barely holding on. But yeah, it'd be good if they start their attack over here. I don't know if they're waiting on, like, other armies to come up. But look at this unit. This unit was on a full 160. It's down to, like, down 50 men already. I'm pretty sure it was a full unit. Certainly it was a healthy one. I mean, this one was certainly very healthy until it's now down to about 40 men left. Look at these poor men. They've just, like, been covered in blood. They've seen so much. They have seen so much blood. And then, yeah, I mean, I feel like they're just trying to get everything ready in position, but they're leaving everything well in range of the elven positions. They clearly, like, have not set up properly. I mean, that's also a huge advantage I've just seen that Dol Amroth has. They have pikes or pole arms, and they're going to be very useful. I mean, they may get focused down by the elven archers. I mean, this is a good thing that possibly, like, the swords are soaking up the ammo of the elven archers, because then they've got less to use on the pole arms when it comes to it. Like, all the archers I can see are probably below half ammo now. Including the general, I would say, yeah. So, I mean, that's a reassuring thing. I mean, they obviously got the towers, so, I mean, there's always going to be that threat there for the pole arms. Unless they bring the artillery up, which is now moving up slowly. So, again, they have artillery. That is another advantage that Dol Amroth has. But the elves have a really strong defensive position. So, it is going to be hard to tell who's going to win this one. They just need to conserve their ammo. For now, because I mean, oh my gosh, look at that. This poor guy just got, like, destroyed. What's it, like a scorpion tower or something? Doesn't say, just a fort tower. But they just have to conserve some ammo and leave it for key units like shock infantry and pole arms. I wouldn't bother shooting these swords now. I think most of their infantry in a one-on-one will probably beat Dol Amroth. Like, Dol Amroth's infantry is good, but it's not, like, exceptional. It's not, it's, like, a faction strength. Their strengths are in their, probably in their cavalry, like, most. Most of their strength. Mainly because they have so many different options. They can bring a cheaper one, they can bring a more expensive one, depending on the funds. So Dol Amroth always has that option of bringing cavalry. Even if it's like, oh yeah, it's like, you don't always bring Swan Knights because Swan Knights are awful. Yeah, if it's a lower fund game, you can bring these like Tarnosian lancers. These guys clearly like proved that they're good enough, and I think they're like nearly half the price or something like that. They're like a lot lower in price, maybe not half the price, but they're sitting like several hundred cheaper, which is like a huge thing in a like a multiplayer game. And then they have the I'm pretty sure they're the Squires or something like that. Dol-Amroth Squires, which are even cheaper. And they're still fairly good. They can get quite a lot of kills. But there you go, the first unit breaking. No surprises. It's like a 41-man unit. They'll probably send up these 89 one next after it's got focused down by stuff. You can see Shock Infantry appearing up here. It's one of the newer units, the Belfast Fleet Warriors. We'll have a look at them for those who haven't seen them. These guys look very cool. They kind of remind me of, they look like a lot of their lower tier, like sword infantry, and then they have like a massive axe and a shield on their back. And these guys are the lower tier shock infantry. They are pretty damn cool. I'm just going to shot them while they're not running for you. Yeah, these guys look pretty cool. But as you can see, I think a lot of stuff's starting to move around to this far right-hand side because there's just the one Seaward Infantry over here on its own. Its lone self. But it needs to just make a decision whether to go up and go or not. But I think Dol-Amroth's not really ready. He's waiting for other stuff to appear. So I am going to make a quick cut here because I have a feeling that the preparation for the next assault is getting ready. So I'll see you guys in a moment. So we're back, and we have the next clash. It's another one of the smaller units of Seaward Infantry that has been sent up to fight. There have been a few little developments apart from that. There's the catapult. It's now set up and ready. I think it is going to probably be taking out these towers on either side, or maybe just destroying like the lines of spears. I'm not quite sure, but it's yet to fire its first salvo. It looks like everyone else is like set up ready to go in where they want to. Like Dol-Amroth is fully surrounded this area. He has archers all the way around here, swords plenty in every way. He's got like a small depot here of like troops. He can either funnel like up this way, or he can funnel like around that way, whichever choke point needs him the most. And then he's got like the rest of his army here, including his pole arms and quite a lot of his shock to go through this one breach here with the artillery as well. And yeah, you can see here these Seaward Infantry already losing. They're gonna need, these elves are gonna need soften up before infantry can really go in. I think they're like, look at this, they're firing so much ammo into this one unit of the elves. I don't think there's any need. They were gonna beat it anyway. It is a weak Dol-Amroth unit against a fresh elven army, or fresh elven unit, sorry. And there you go, they've broken and gone. There's another unit ready, take its place. Don't know where they're gonna get sent up. We might want to send up, like, I don't know, send up swords with some skirmishers or something like that, and just, like, I don't know, just see if you can, skirmish these, like, units down maybe a bit. Maybe. It might be worth the idea. Certainly, I don't know how many archers, I only got two arch units on that side. Maybe not then. These skirmishers aren't that great. They're very light, so they don't take a lot of hits before they'll start dying. So it's a tough one. There's always that risk. It looks like on the other side, they're looking like they're going to get ready to go up. It looks like they're going to go up in that, like, sort of arrowhead formation. Very cool. Very cool. Look at it. All the officers are, like, so bloodied up. He's like, I've just killed so many elves, and I'm ready to kill more. But it's actually probably his blood. It's probably his own blood from, like, being shot. I don't think this unit's actually seen action yet. Oh, God, he's already gone down. The officer has. Went down like a stone. Yeah, I don't think these Dol-Amroth troops will take out many of these spears. They're in spear wall, on top of a massive like staircase. And they're fresh. I could be wrong, obviously. The elves might absolutely crumble. Swords should beat spears, but that's not necessarily the case when it's elven spears. Yeah, nowhere else is really attacking yet. He's attacking in like little bits every so often. So like he failed on this side over here. Now he's now attacking this side. He really needs to attack all simultaneously. Try and like cause the elven players to do a little bit more micro. Right now it's a little bit too easy for him. This elven chap here just coming out of formation. He'll perish for that. Never break your shield wall. The shield wall is your life. Look at him, he's well out of formation. Get stabbed in the back right now. That guy just grew, decided to just stab him in the back, he could. But they do look great. Oh, the Elven, Wooden Realms always do look the best, I think. Or, like, certainly one of the best. So does Dol Amroth. I think Dol Amroth looks really good as well. In, like, comparison to, like, some of the other factions, I think they look absolutely amazing. Looks like they've attacked on that side as well. I think it's just that tiny unit's gone back in, yeah. The new attack down here, I think this is probably one of the easiest places to attack. They also have a lot of archers here. I mean, that could be useful. Certainly, like, taking out their general, probably not a bad idea. Or weakening him. Certainly, these Lords of Lasgarlan are pretty nasty. And they do look awesome. But we'll see. I mean, they've got archers just about everywhere. This is the weakest spot, clearly, because it has the least amount of archers, which is possibly why Dol Amroth's focusing a lot of stuff here. But I would start getting more resources. Start possibly shunting across some shock infantry over here. And then you're going to force them to bring archers from other places, like here, for instance. This is the only unit I've just realized that has full ammo. There is a unit with full ammo, okay. But yeah, this unit here will then have to come shunt across, deal with the shock infantry. And he needs to send a massive push up here again with more shock infantry. I think that's what he has to do. Well, at the same time, also attacking here. I think these elven units here, these ones with the arrows or bows, they're nearly out of ammo. Like, I mean, who's... I mean, they could possibly take out some shock infantry in a pike unit or a polearm unit, but they couldn't take many more waves of swords. I mean, they can offer a few more waves of swords. Not many, actually, to be fair, on this side. They're pretty low on anything, but, like, on swords, basically, put it like that. They have two fresh units, and that's it. This catapult needs to get working. Hopefully it's firing. What's it firing at? I think it is firing at the Lords of Lasgarlan, which is a shame. They should really take... Oh, no, they have been firing at the towers. Yeah, they are firing at the towers. Smart. I think that's a smart thing to do. These towers probably actually are helping get, like, a masses of kills. And it's a permanent, like, ranged threat. While these archers eventually will run out of ammo, the towers will just have endless ammo. Which is just one of the broken things in Attila. And they also fire, like, machine guns, so... That makes it even worse. I mean, this unit here, I'm pretty sure this unit here has been, like, slowly chipped away by the tower. It's ridiculous. It's down to 20. Oh, no! It's getting chipped away by archers as well. Again, what's the point? I don't see what the point of the, like, archers is to just shoot these units. I mean, yeah, you're routing it, but... I think you're wasting ammo on that unit. That unit would have easily just got taken out by the spears. It would have run onto the spears, and they would have died. To save your ammo for, like, other archers, shock infantry, like I've said. I just feel like the elves are freely using their arrows and not thinking about what the consequences will be when they run out. Like, Dol Amroth just has to wait, play it slowly, let his swords basically take all the arrow fire, then send up the nasty stuff like the Haven Guard and the pikes and his own archers. And then he's in trouble. I mean, that is... Look at that poor man there, just getting skewered. Yeah, I think they've broken that unit as well. I mean, they've got plenty of, like, elves here. That's the thing, there's so many. There's another sword unit ready just to take its place. This is insane. Like, Dol Amroth was quite happy to send up one unit at a time. I mean, it's the best thing to do. You don't want to get blobbed in this scenario. Oh, destroy this tower. That might kill a few of these guys. Don't know if it did. It might kill, like, one or two. I mean, everything counts at this point, but yeah, you can see, look at the Seaward Infantry unit. It's like just getting rinsed. These elves are slowly chipping through their ammo, though, to try and break it. If anything, they should just send up the swords with a shock infantry unit and actually go into combat. Then they'd probably see more of an achievement. Because then at least the swords will protect the, like, shock infantry a bit, and the shock infantry can help the swords in breaking through. And they can actually see some sort of, like, I don't know, progress being made. Because right now, Dol Amroth is not making any progress. I think they've got two different game plans. There's two obvious game plans going on. Dol Amroth's just being patient, waiting until there's better stuff is needed to, well, win the game. I mean, the numbers still way in his favor. Obviously, the elves, like I've said, they're very elite, so they obviously have got a good chance themselves. But they like Dolan's game plan, basically patience is what I was trying. I just had like a mind blank, and then the elves are just basically going for like annihilation. Anything that like turns upon their doorstep, it's getting killed instantly. Which, I mean, fair enough. As a defender, you kind of have to. If you let the enemy build up too much in one area, if you're defending, then you're probably going to get punished. They just got to limit ammo and slow these guys down. Not attacking anywhere else, still. Looks like Dolomath is moving some Tarnation Spears, though. These guys are exhausted. I thought they've been resting here for quite a while. I thought these guys have been fresh like everyone else, but maybe not. I'm glad that the elves don't have catapults, because otherwise this would be make a juicy like target here with all these blobbed up troops. And, like, same over there. Like, there's another good blob of troops there. Like, yeah, good thing the elves don't have catapults. I think that's a good balancing feature that they've thrown in. You don't need to have catapults if you're going to assault as the elves. Your archers are basically catapults in themselves. Just that they fire hundreds of tiny little needles instead of one massive rock. Love the elven officer here with like his double-handed sword and his silver armor. It's kind of weird that like silver armor in like certainly in the Wooden Realm is actually more of the elite sign, like the noble sign, and like gold is like the just normality. It's kind of weird. Here we go, Shark Infantry coming up. We got some Belfast Fleet Warriors, and they should make some progress. I mean, they should cut down these spears pretty easily if they get left to it. Yeah, I imagine so. Someone else come up behind it. Seaward Infantry. Now they're starting to really like send some troops in, really trying to commit. I like to see that by Dolanos. Trying to take the game by the scruff of the neck. I'm just surprised the elves haven't started opening fire. It's like the first target that they can shoot quite happily and get quite a lot of kills with, probably. Because the missile block is just terrible. More elves going down, more or less Garden Blades. Yeah, these arrows here, I mean, maybe they're saving them for the pikes. Maybe they just have that small amount left, like, right, this is for pikes, and that's it. But are they seriously going to just let these Belfast Marine, or the Belfast Fleet Warriors, sorry, just, like, chop through their lines? I mean, they're not, they probably won't get the whole way through, but they could certainly do a sizable dent. But as always, it looks glorious. And it looks like they're still fighting up on this side. They've sent in more infantry, actually. Surprised we haven't seen any Knights of Imrahil or something like that. Apart from the general, I don't think they have actually brought any Knights of Imrahil themselves. So that's kind of a shame. Because they definitely could have done a lot of work. Just look at that, the banner just drooping left in the dirt. Someone pick up the banner. Cannot let the banner of Dol Amroth fall to the ground. Interesting to see how many kills some of these elven units will have got. Like, there's a few certain spear units that I have a feeling are going to have got hundreds of kills, possibly. Archers certainly will have. And here we go. You can see arrows now firing. They're firing the precious like remain of like ammo they have here. You can see they brought around the other Lascalon archer unit with like a lot of ammo. Now's the time. Push up here. I mean, they have the Lords of Lasgallon, but, like, hardly any ammo. I mean, this is certainly an area they want to push. There's no ammo here left. And eventually, I think that unit will have to go over there. And they are going to have at least one area permanently that will always have, like, no archer support. You can see they're firing the Amorithian Arch Militia. That's good. I mean, I'm sure that Dolan was probably pretty pleased with this, because these guys are just terrible. So, like, them taking up the arrows, like, and wasting ammo of the elves is probably just what they wanted. probably part of the game plan. It's certainly saving like their Belfast fleet warriors from getting a untimely death from an arrow from above. A bit of progress, I would say. A bit of progress. Those arch militia nearly gone already, so they'll soon start turning their direction of like anger of the arrows will go into these swords here in the shock infantry. Start to see more shock infantry come up. This is some nasty shock infantry. This is the Haven Guard. We saw them earlier. A different unit, but they were still just as deadly. Hopefully they don't put these guys in archer range. I wouldn't send them in just yet. I wouldn't have sent them in just yet. There's still plenty of Dol Amroth troops down there doing their bit. They're pulling back troops, actually. They're pulling back the fresh swords. They need them somewhere else. Quite possibly. I mean, they're losing here now, the spears. The archers, I think so, have a little bit of ammo. They need to be careful, or they have just been sent in. There's a Hall Guardians. There's a Haven Guard up here. If only there was Hall Guardians, then the elves would certainly be sorted. Those guys are nasty. There's like some guy just shouting, have you seen the Standard Bearer? It's like, yes, the Standard's like in the ground somewhere. Look at this guy. He's like planting the Dol Amroth spear on top of the steps. He's like, we made it, men. We've made it to the top of the steps. And now we fight on to the next layer. Call it the Battle of the Steps. The elves are slowing down this assault. Even with the Haven Guard here, they're slowing this down quite nicely. Whether that small unit of swords will make it to the defences, I don't think so. I think it's probably just going to break instantly. Is there artillery ammo left? I think there was, but they stopped using it now. Did they all use it all on these towers? Surely not. They're like, surely they like... I mean, actually, no. It looks like they're taking out archers at points. That's not a bad idea, but I mean... I just take out more infantry. The archers won't stand long if you get rid of the infantry. So here, these arrows come down. I think most of them are hitting into the Dol Amroth ranks, not into the Lasgarlan ranks. So, I mean, that's a good sign. You look at that. These just five or six men here just standing and watching. It's like, yes. Come and face us. Oh, no. Poor men. No. He's got skewered by an arrow. Oh, no. Gee, yeah, look at the size of that, like, bolt. It is huge. This guy's just, like, got one in his, like, shield. He's absolutely champion. And now he's dead. Oh, dear. I think that whole unit just died there and then, really. Oh, no. There's still two of them alive. Well, that's a sad sight. We just watched... murder take place. I mean, we watch murder take place just about every battle and every scene you show us, Pope, but just get upset at a few men getting shot by scorpion bolts all of a sudden. And there you go, it looks like the elves are going to fall back. I don't know if that was really a wise move. They were holding that stairway quite well. But yeah, they're going to fall back. They're allowed the Haven Guard to get like well up onto the steps now. I mean, they're mixed in with the units, so maybe that was their plan. Haven Guard have just committed so far into the unit that they're, like, trapped in the middle, and they could just easily get cut down by the elves. And I think they are, actually. I think that's what's happening. Yeah, look at this. He's Haven Guard losing now. That is a big play there by the elves. He kind of just lured them in, and they've now then done the dirty on the Haven Guard, and they've just cut these guys down. These poor guys, they're down, like, they were like over 100, now down to about 67, 68. Elves now being under threat on this side, finally for the first time as well. I mean, those first five or six men were just the scout reconnaissance. Here we go, we have actual proper unit up here now. They really need to send them in. They can't just have them, like, just stood here. Otherwise, you saw what happened to the first, like, six. They just get, like, absolutely focused down. We've got pikes up now, or pole arms. Obviously, it's the Prince's Coast Guard. You can see here, getting focused down with arrows. Instantly, as soon as they appear, the Lords of the Last Guard just open up. And they're going to just focus these guys down. It's a real shame. They need to get a move on and get in to mix with this unit. And also, like, so the Lords of the Last Guard can't get the angle. No, don't fall back. You need to be in there. You need to go in there. You need to go in, face them. So there's still a whole mix of stuff down here, and the catapult crews join the fight. Those mere, like, 40-odd men that, like, get sent in, they're going to make the difference, apparently. I mean, the elves are getting pushed back. You can kind of see where the fighting started and now where it is. The elves are losing ground. But are they losing it quickly enough? I don't know. There's like a shield wall on each side, and there's like a little bit of a no man's land in the middle where like duels just meet and happen.
Our men return to the fight.
Over on this side, they're doing quite a good job. They were at one point. They look like they're doing a good job because they were in behind, but they're losing now with this unit. The elves are equally in a bit of trouble here. All these units here are losing. I think this is like code red for the elves here. They're sending over like arch units without any ammo left. If I was Dolaroth, I'd be pouring at more stuff. Have they got more stuff? Yeah, they've got Haven Guard coming around here. Oh no, it's Fleet Warriors. Fleet Warriors and, yeah, I think just both Fleet Warriors. So interesting to see what they can do with these guys. See whether they can get them in. See, it's just so bizarre. They sent Haven Guard in first. Like, why would you do that? You send in your Fleet Warriors first. They're the cheapest. You always leave your expenses till last, or you should. The pole arms over here, not doing much in the way of killing. Probably more in the way of dying. They've lost nearly 50 men. I'm just getting sniped off by this tower. It's so frustrating, I'm sure, for the attacker. What's the numbers looking like now? There's only 1,000 difference. I mean, in the time that we've last checked, I think like the attackers have lost 1,400 men and the defenders have lost about 500. So, I mean, going off that ratio, I think it's going to be a close run thing. But it's getting ever so slightly harder and harder for the elves. Oh my gosh, this is a nice angle. Look at this. These Javis here just throwing into the flank of the elves, filling them with Javis. Oh my gosh, yeah, this is nice. This is nice. I'm surprised not firing on these guys with archers. I thought that would be a unit you'd be leaving ammo for. They have no ammo here actually now. Where did that other unit go with ammo? Did it run out? Surely not. I think it's run out. I think it's gone. I think they've lost all their ammo. Apart from like the general, Lords of the Last Garland over here, he's got a little bit of ammo left. And there you go, the elves have lost at the bottom of those stairs. The Seaward Infantry have won. At what cost? Well, probably several hundred men. Those Javis need to stop firing. They don't need to kill those guys. They need to save their ammo for the next wave. You can see Hall Guardians now coming up next. They're going to probably do a lot of issues for these spears here. And here we go, the elves are now starting to feel the squeeze. They've lost most of their like outer defenses at the bottom of the steps or like at the foot of these towers. I mean, they're actually pushing back here. They pushed them way down the stairs. This is a real, true battle for these stairs. I like it. See the Belfast Fleet Warriors getting intermingled again with the Elven lines. That's how the Haven Guard died, and I'm sure they'll die just as quickly, if not quicker. There you go. You can see the game pushed back quite hard, the Dolinar troops here. Yeah, you can see a wavering unit of Belfast Fleet Warriors, 98, 94 now. They don't do so well. They don't do so well. They're not as good as the Haven Guard. There's a massive stark difference between the two units. And already this flank over here for Dol Amroth, all gone. Basically everything for Dol Amroth is now thrown in. It's now trying to break through these areas. And we can see the Haven Guard over here. I mean, they've just got to hold on. They've got to like re-rally and just be a persistent so all those elves over there cannot rejoin. Because, I mean, they'll definitely break through here with Dol Amroth if everything stays as it is. And they're falling back. Why is Dolanov doing this? Oh, maybe he's going to bring the Javis up. He's actually using the Javis right now. He needs to get them really close. He needs to get them, like, really close. Have a sword unit to support, so if they get countercharged, they'll be safe. But yeah, you can see it's the same on this side as well. More Javis being sent up. I'm sure these guys are, like, doing a bit of damage, yeah. But at the same time, they're also probably getting shot by stuff like archer towers. Who knows? See it from their perspective. Just throwing it a solid, like, wall of bronze, gold, whatever it is. I don't think I could kill an elf if I had to. Like, I mean, they're immortal. Why would you, like, something that's lived so long? Like, then just end it there and then. It's kind of sad to think of it like that. Like, these poor, like, these fishermen here have possibly killed, like, immortal elves that have, like, walked the earth since its creation. And these fishermen with, like, a tiny little javi just gone, ha. I've ended all that here and now. Kind of weird when you think it like that. Obviously, I know, like, Dol Amroth and the elves never did fight each other. So those fishermen in lore never got the chance to do that. But you can see, we have Knights of Imladris in here now. The general has been thrown in. Don't know if that was really necessary, but I mean, they now have the two best units probably in this roster and some of the best units in this game fighting in combat here. These Knights of Imladris and these Haven Guard, they are, well, they should break through here. These archers are getting sliced apart. The spears won't be too much longer after. The general has just about got a little bit of ammo left. You can see the elves now flanking around hard. They're going to try and flank the Dol Amroth position. And you see they're putting pikes in the way to stop it. It's very smart. Very smart. So the pikes have now gone from offensive duties to defensive duties. Interesting to see what they can do. I mean, they'd have to go a long, long way around if they want to go and catch where the general is. But that's not going to be the case. I mean, they can now easily overwhelm the spear unit. It's charging down as well. They need to like countercharge with their own shock infantry. Oh, yeah, they're going to catch a lot of these fishermen. These fishermen who ended so many elven lives are now going to have their own lives ended. But yeah, look at, wow, they actually fell back everything. Why did Dol Amroth do that? He definitely could have taken that sword unit. He needed it to break out a shield wall. That's what he needed to do, and oh no. And now he's actually going to come down and face the elves here in this little street. I mean, he definitely could have just, I mean, maybe he was kind of concerned about them going all the way around. Maybe it was the case, but I think they were okay. I don't think they had to worry about it. If I was Dol Amroth, I'd be putting my archers here, like fire into the flanks as they, or into the rear as the swords fight out with the pole arms. That's what I would be doing. And we can see the swords here are going to defend at the bottom of this hill. That's not a bad idea. And they could hopefully clean up a fair amount of these elven troops here. I don't know. I mean, numbers now. Oh dear, elves have just gone like sub 1,000. And I mean, Dol Amroth's not far off joining. I mean, they are closing the gap, are the elves, and that every time they close the gap, battle goes in their favor a little bit. Oh, look at that elf. Oh my gosh. He's just got like a he's like punching some man to death. And then he's been stabbed to death. Oh. What a nice kill by the Knight of Imladris there. some cool kill animations in this game. It's probably why it takes so long for the modders to do anything, because they've got to do all these kill animations for every single unit. It is so complex. Sometimes I cannot imagine how much work goes into just creating like one unit to do like so many things. It's so smart. I have only the utmost respect for the modders of this. Well, this mod and just about any other mod. I'm good at talking about them, but I don't think I'll be very good at making them. Still a fair amount of Dol Amroth troops down there. Is that the general that's fallen back? No, it's Haven Guard. They're getting sent somewhere else. I think they are. Oh, because the pole arm's broken. They broke really quickly. How did that happen? Maybe they just went into combat, I guess, and lost, maybe? They took a lot of elves down with them, in fairness. I mean, now the elves obviously can surround that sword unit there. That's pretty much doomed it. The archers I just would have had here, like I said, just that would have supported the pole arms so well. They're going to try and reform the pole arms up quickly, but the damage is done. They're too few in number now to stop anything. Lasgarlan archers leading the way, destroying these last few units on this flank. Now Dol Amroth surrounded, and he knows the true meaning of fear. Apparently this battle's still got 15 minutes still to run. Jeez, this is an insanely long one. I hope you guys have still been enjoying it. I certainly have been. It's been thoroughly enjoyable seeing how close this one's come down to like the wire. Two well-matched armies. They're just like Dol Amroth just seems to like been going uphill constantly. Like it's just been an uphill battle. But so far he's kind of met nearly every challenge. Apart from his pole arms breaking, he's probably met nearly every challenge and found a way to outwit it. And the elves are just holding on, just killing dozens of men by the like by the second. But these Dol Amroth troops just drop so much quicker than the elves, but every time the elves lose like one or two men or like a whole unit, that's a big loss for them. Swords here, they will break soon. I mean, Dol Amroth at that sort of stage, though, if he loses just a single whole unit, that's a big loss for him as well. You can see, like, the remains of what happened on this the top of the steps here, in the Battle of the Steps, as I'm calling it. So many dead. So many dead. Cavalry as well. Jeez. They threw everything in here. They truly did. We have the floating horses as well. Yeah, that is a pretty nasty scrap that they had there. And there, the flank on this side has finally been defeated as well. Dol Amroth is, now just stuck with this issue here. He's now got a Javis here. And he's got some, shock infantry to defend everything that's coming around here. I don't know if it's going to be enough. I do not know if it's going to be enough. These Haven Guard, they're fresh. Or fairly fresh. They might be able to take out a fair few of those units, but I don't know about all of them. I mean, the elves are playing a big risk here themselves. They're sending the rest of their army all the way around here. Like, if they break through here, Dol Amroth, then they can just go straight for this point here, and then they just have to defend it. And they win. So it will be... they will look very silly, will the elves, if they do lose this choke point here. I mean, there is two very strong spear units holding the line, so it doesn't look like they're going anytime soon. The shock infantry, the Haven Guard just can't get through. Gotta remember, on this side as well, there's no towers to help them. They have no towers here to the elves. So this is all the elven work here. All the elven efficiency and, like, eloquence in battle. I don't even know if that'll be the right thing to use. Can you look eloquent in battle? Probably. These archers here, they're just going to stand and shoot everything that's down here. It's not a bad idea. Weaken these elves up ever more. I'll be shooting their swords. Certainly these archers have no chance fighting the Haven Guard. I just let the... and if the elves charge up, just use the Fisherman Levy just to slow down any sort of a charge bonus for the elves. The general's losing here. They dismounted Knights of Imrahil, losing this fight here. I don't think they have enough. Let's have a look at numbers quickly. Yeah, balance power is now massively in favor of the elves. 783 to 600 elves. And as soon as the odds balance up, or like the numbers balance up, the elves just get a massive balance power boost because they're just so good. But they've done a really, really good job, the elves. And you can see here, Dolomar's falling back. I don't know if he's had a chain route or no. He's just retreating off the top of here. Interesting, interesting. I don't know. I don't know what his plan is, really. Is he thinking, can I just defeat this force here first, then turn everything around, and then go back up here? I quite possibly could be. I think he's going to just have the long game for a little bit and shoot these elves up here with his archer militia. Well, that's really going to do anything. They're firing to a shield wall. Yeah, you can't see many elves dropping, or if any. So, that's not really working as that tactic already. I hate to say it. They're firing here as well. You need to be careful. The elves are starting to appear. What, Haven Guard going forward. There you go. Some sort of a clash there between the lines. Fishermen getting sent in as well. They'll be selling their goods whilst cutting down elves. Like, who wants some, I don't know, 3 gold pieces for a bit of haddock or, I don't know, cod. Don't know what they would be on about. I don't know what fish there are in Middle Earth. Probably trout. Probably the same ones that you have in England since Tolkien wrote the book. There you go, the fishermen. It's clear the fishermen that are doing the damage, even though they're losing and wavering already, fighting all these elves. I mean, yeah, but the Haven Guard here doing a nice little job, chopping down all these guys. I mean, what is left now? I mean, if you could take out the general, might cause a chain route for the elves. Over on this side, you can see the elves have actually pushed down. They're backfighting at the bottom of these stairs, like where it all began on this flank. That's going to be disheartening enough for the Dol Amroth troops. Like, after all that like progress you made, you're just backfighting where you were before. Look at these four chaps, they just got left at the top of the stairs. You just defending the stairs in case anyone comes up. Very good of you. But yeah, I don't think these Haven Guard got a good charge, if any charge, so I think they're having a really tough time. Excellent. I mean, excellent for the elves anyway. Not so excellent for the Haven Guard, who actually are losing decisively. But, I mean, they are winning on this side decisively against the general. The Lords of Lasgarlan getting pushed back. Elven Spears coming up, though. They might help save their general. I don't know where the general is. He's in there somewhere, I presume. God, this mod in the right light can look so beautiful sometimes. Or, like, really beautiful. How are the Haven Guard doing that? They're still winning this fight. They're still winning this fight. And the general is still losing that fight. So, I mean, there's still the hope of a chain route. I mean, I don't know if the general over here. Enemy general has died just like that. He just died. Oh, dear. There's a little bit too late to pull him out. Might as well just send him back in. Just need the bodies there. They could possibly sneak around here, could the elves. They can get a unit around there. It's possibly an option. Yeah, I mean, now the Haven Guard back to, like, just even since they've not find the general anymore. It's just that they got that good charge off. And, I mean, will these units now break over here? I wonder. I mean, they're kind of a little bit... Well, I mean, they might, but then at the same time, the Haven Guard are losing this fight. So they might break. They might need to send these Amrothian Archer militia soon. Spears here. Look at this. Spears. There's 9 spears, and they're winning against all these fishermen. Come on, guys. There's 60 of you. 60 of you, and you're hungry for a deal for your fish. You could probably kill the rest of these guys. Three separate little fights going on now. Personally, I don't see the elves losing any of them, like, decisively. I mean, they are winning. I think they're winning this one by just holding. I mean, the elves are actually losing here. Both the units are losing. So maybe not. Maybe they're not. But yeah, there you go. The fishermen went. They need to just shoot these spears. Just break them. And there's only 9 of them, but they can't just risk them getting behind and just flanking these Hall Guardians. Or just even kill, like, all these archer militia. They probably could do that as well. Hall Guardians now losing here pretty decisively. The spears on the other side, though, losing decisively for the elves. Find those Knights of Imrahil, I think. Or is it the Sea Ward Infantry? I don't know. No, Knights of Imrahil. I was going to say the general is a... Certainly can't be a Sea Ward Infantry unit. They're losing faith again. Those fishermen. There's still 30 of them. 30 of them to take down 9 men. They could do it. Maybe not. But yeah, the Hall Guardians, I mean, they really need to cycle out possibly and, like, let someone else go in so they can get a better charge bonus again. But they have nothing to, obviously, they can cycle with. So that's the issue. The shock infantry have just been left in combat just to basically endure a slow death. And I think the elves have got this. See, the 200... men for the elves against 400 Dol Amroth troops. This is getting ridiculous now. I mean, they closed the gap to about 100, but I think Dol Amroth opened it up against about a 200-man advantage. And obviously, the elves lost the general, but this doesn't seem to be slowing them down. They can break this spear and then get behind the other. There's a chance. There is a chance they'll just chain out all these guys here. Back on this side, I mean, yeah, you can see the elves, like the 9 elven spears just surrounding them. Like, yes, you will surrender. We have got you surrounded. It's 9 men. We're not going to surrender. It's like, it's more than 9. You just can't see the rest of us. But yeah, they actually, these Haven Guard are getting cut down pretty quickly now. So the longer they stay in combat, the shocking just gets worse. They actually shoot now into the back of those Lasgallan spears. That's a risk because you're going to miss a lot of shots and hit your own men. You can see they're losing slightly. That's not good, yeah. They need to send these archers and get them, like, I don't know, if you can set them up here and shoot over the top. That's not a bad idea. Don't know whether they can do that. I mean, the elves are losing on this side, though. This is interesting. They are losing slightly, and then on this side, losing decisively. I think it's these arrows here, just point blank shooting into the sides of them. They're taking out probably some of their own Haven Guard, but it's a risk worth taking at this point. There you go, the Haven Guard is gone. Dismounted Knights of Imrahil finally surrounding these elves. And the other elves pushing up now. They're going to try and engage these archer militia. Oh, he's coming down right to the brink of, like, who's just got more? Who's got more of a will? Who's got more morale? 57 men for the Haven Guard. And they're winning this fight now, apparently. After, like, being shot in their own back, they decided, nah, we're going to carry on fighting. I mean, these two units, the swords and spears, are pretty damn low. The spears are starting to waver. And the archers, we already know that the archers of Lords of Lasgallen can't fend themselves off against these shock infantry, so it is going to be seriously close. I wonder whether if they had some Hall Guardians, these elves, they might be able to do it. But you can see here the Lasgallen Spears are now going to engage these Archer Militia. And you wonder whether this one's going to shoot into the backs of the Spears, try and break it. Hopefully get some decent kills from that. There you go, you can see first volley comes in. I don't know if they got many kills, but need to be getting some kills soon. They're still firing on this side as well, firing point blank. Everyone's firing an arrow when possible. And the swords here breaking, though. Now the elves are winning this decisively. What is this? This is insane. The elves here are losing this, which is no surprise. They're getting shot on the back by the arch militia. They might want to keep some of the arrow, like, ammo available for, like, I don't know, taking out anything else. Because it now looks like these Haven Guard are going to lose here. What is this? What actually is this? You were winning, like, 2 seconds ago. Now, all of a sudden, when the archers move in a different direction, that's it. That's clearly it. Like, the archers for the Lanroth are going to be the make or break. They could help. They can help whatever flank they want. And now the general's winning in his fight against the Lasgallen Spears. This is just nuts. Nuts. And he's not losing this one anymore as Haven Guard. It keeps just chopping and changing. You see now the archers are losing on this side. Apparently everyone's losing in this fight. As is the way of war. There is no winners. A general has died. There we go. Dolanroth general has died. That I personally think is going to be enough. I think the elves have like dealt with having their general dead for a little while and not broken. So if they're not going to break, if they haven't broken now, they're not going to break ever, I don't think. So they still might beat this unit though. They might still beat this unit. I mean, the archers here need to support and support what remains of the general unit. What are we down to in men? 208 to 83 elves. This is insane. 83. He's not even got 100 men left. Nuts. This battle is nuts. It's going to come down to the last few hundred men, isn't it? Yeah. This is... Oh my gosh. These elves are getting absolutely annihilated by the archers. This general unit just needs to hold on. He's got 50 dismounted knights in here. That's quite a lot of men. And both these units here are wavering. Okay, so the general unit... Yeah, we shouldn't expect the general unit to win this after he died so easily. And these Haven Guard have 14 men left and they're going to win this fight. These guys have literally gone through hell. And there you go, the elves broken on that side. It won't be a matter, it'll be only a matter of time till they break here. You can see they're wavering. And that is going to be it. I honestly thought the elves had it. And no. You can see Dolanroth has won by a mere, like, 100 or so men. So we'll end the replay and have a look at the end results. So that is the definition of a Pyrrhic victory. There is literally no one left alive to fight. Or, like, even pick up the bodies, really. We'll have a quick look at Dolanroth, who was played by Coolbreeze, who sent this replay in. So thank you very much for sending this replay in. It was an excellent, excellent replay. But yeah, so his general getting 100 kills, which is pretty low for Knights of Imrahil. Like, you can see a lot of his Seaward infantry, like, got, like, no kills because he just got focused down. His best one getting 167. And then these Belfast Fleet Warriors here getting 53 kills. Not very good. Like, in comparison to, say, like, the Haven Guard, the worst one got 111. 367, another one got on 428. These guys do nasty amounts of work. The Coast Guards, Prince's Coast Guard, I thought he had two, but clearly he had one, and it was only got 29 kills. That's 129, sorry. That's okay. Not too bad. His Arch Militia didn't do that much, but in the end, they were the clutch at the end of the day, getting, like, those few kills needed just to break those spears. A Jabba unit here getting 118, which is pretty solid, and a Carry unit getting 157, while the other one got zero. Jeez. But yeah, so, I mean, those Tarnosian Lancers did okay to start with. I thought they did actually okay. 157 is not too bad for them. And then we have the Wooden Realm here, the Lords of Lasgallen. 309 kills. Wow. With both bows and swords, they did really well. His Lasgallen Blades, 337, 226, 300. On now we're onto the spears. 306 for the spears, 233, 209. Some insane kills there. Then we've got, like, Lasgallen archers here. Not a few of these not doing very well because they got trapped on the walls. But, like, 217, 253, 253, 351. Wow, they got some really good kills. So well done to Ghost, who was playing as the Wooden Realm. He did very, very well, as did Cool Breeze. Thank you again for playing this battle and for sending it in. And then I hope you guys enjoyed anyway. If you did, well, what else have I got to do? Literally comes down to the last few hundred men. That is the closest battle I think you're ever going to see. If you enjoy seeing close battles anyway, do feel free to come check out the channel again. Leave a like, subscribe if you're new around here, and a comment to show your support for Rise of Mordor or just for the channel. And always appreciate it as always, guys. Love your support. And until next time, Legionnaires,